you Dr. Seuss. He's my second favorite doctor behind Dr. Dre. I found this in Bruce Wayne's library. Just what he calls himself.
Some bitch.
The rabbit felt mighty important that day, atop the hill, in the sun where he lay. He felt so important up there on that hill, that he started in bragging, as animals will, like bats. And he thought it out loud and he grabbed his chest. Of all the beasts in the world, I'm the best, like Bane. On land and on sea, even up in the sky, no animal lives who is better than I. There are pictures in here that no children have colored in. What's that girl's voice? That was terribly gruff. So what do you say? Such ridiculous stuff. Rock looked down and he saw a big bear. I'm best of the beast, said the bear. And so there. You're not, snapped the rabbit. I'm better than you. Pooh, the bear snorted. Again, I said pooh. You talk mighty big, Mr. Rabbit. That's true. But how can you prove it? Just what can you do? Oh, thought the rabbit. Now what can I do? He thought and he thought, then he finally said, of course, Mr. Bear. Do you see these 2 ears on my head? My ears are so keen and so sharp and so fine. No ears in the world can hear further than mine. That motherfucker. After the bear grunted, he looked at each ear. You say they are good, said the bear with a sneer. But how do I know? Just how far can they hear? I'll prove it, said the rabbit. My ears are the best. You sit there and watch me. I'll prove it by test. Then he stiffened his ears, like an erection. They both stood up right and pointed straight up at the blue of the sky. He stretched his ears open as wide as he could. I'm still listening, he said as he stood. He listened so hard that he started to sweat. And the fur on his forehead, and his forehead got wet. There's a lot of pages for Bane to read here. I haven't read since I was a child. When I was born in the darkness. It was as dark as Wesley Snipes. For 7 long minutes he stood, then he stared. And he said to the bear, you know what I heard? You see that far mountain? It's 90 miles off. There's a fly on that mountain. I just heard him cough. Smile. Fly, sir, it's quite hard to hear when he's 90 miles off. But I heard it quite clear. You see, begged the rabbit, it's perfectly true. But my ears are the best, so I'm better than you. The bear for a moment just soaked as he sat. I knew that his ears couldn't hear things like that. This rabbit, he thought, made a fool out of me. I've got to prove that I'm better than he. So I said to the rabbit, you hear pretty well. You can hear 90 miles, but how far can you smell? I'm the greatest of smellers, he bragged. See my nose? The nose on my face is the finest that grows. My nose can smell anything, both far and near. With my nose, I can smell twice as far as you hear. Are you single? I will break you. Pain only does triceps and arm muscles. Pick up a grown man and break his spine. I digress. You can't snap the rabbit. I can drown the bear. And he stuck his big nose way high up in the air. He wiggled that nose and he sniffed and he snuffed. He wiggled that nose and he whipped and he walked. For more than 10 minutes he snuffed and he snuffed. Undo the rabbit, he said. I smell far enough. All right, said the rabbit. Come on now and tell. Exactly how far is that smell that you smell? Oh, I'm smelling a very far smell. Must have farted. Said the bear. Away past that high on that mountain out there. I'm smelling past many great mountains beyond, 600 miles more to the edge of a pond. And way, way out there by the pond you can see is a very small farm. On that farm is a tree. On the tree is a branch, and the branch is a nest, a small nest where two tiny eggs rest. Two hummingbird eggs, only half an inch long. But my nose, said the bear, is so wonderfully strong. My nose is so good that I smell without fail. But the egg on the left is a little bit stale. And that is a thing that no rabbit can do. Read this line, Mouse.
So you see, the bear boasted, I'm better than you. My smeller's so keen that it just can't be beat.
Thank you, I was having trouble. What's that called, a voice from way down by his feet? The bear and the rabbit looked down at the ground. And they saw an old worm crawling out of the ground. Now, boy, said the worm, you've been bragging a lot. You both think you're great, but I think you are not. You're not half as good as a fellow like me. You hear and you smell, but how far can you see? Now I'm here to prove you, big boasting guys, that your nose and your ears aren't as good as my eyes.
And the little old worm cocked his head to one side, and he opened his eyes, and he opened them wide. And they looked far away with a strange sort of stare, as if they were burning two holes in the air. The eyes of that worm almost popped from his head. He stared half an hour till his eyelids got red. That's enough, growled the bear, told the rabbit and me. How far did you look, and just what did you see? Well, boys, am I right? That look that I took was a look that took farther than you'll ever look. What's distracting you, people? I look across the ocean way out to Japan, and I can see farther than anyone can. There's no one on earth who has eyesight that's finer. I look past Japan, oh my belief of shadows. I looked across China, I looked across Egypt, and took a quick glance across the two countries of Holland and France. France doesn't fight. And I looked across England and also Brazil. But I didn't stop there. I looked much farther still. And I kept right on looking and looking until I looked out in the world and right back to the shelf. And I saw on the shelf some of my eyes. You're being a fool that I never see. And the fools that I saw were none